that now in jeopardy, the fact that you're talking with Jerry Jones, and that would kill all of Penn Tech if you went into Cowboy Stadium?
I don't know. Yeah, obviously, that's a big arena, and, you know, who knows what we'll do. Texas is a good market for us, but I don't think you guys are understanding what I'm telling you. This is the market. This is it. This is the biggest market in the world. And I say it all the time. The no-brainers for me were the United States, Mexico, and the UK. Traditionally, big fight fans, you know, lots of great fighters have come from all three of those countries. You know, Canada is not known as one of those places. And the way that this sport just took off and is so huge here, not only are there so many rabid fans here, but so much great talent coming out of Canada. The numbers, the pay-per-view numbers here are outstanding, and everywhere we go, if you look at anywhere in the world we put on an event, and we can track exactly where ticket sales are coming from, it's mind-boggling how many of them are from Canada. And we do these Q&As before the fights, and, you know, if you even say the word Canada, the place starts going crazy, and there's just everywhere, if I'm on the streets and you meet people, everybody's from Canada. It's insane. Talking about, you know, a country that doesn't have that huge population, and there's people everywhere when we put on these mixed martial arts events anywhere in the world.
You mentioned you hate Showtime. Have you seen Dexter?
Huh? No, I've never seen it, but people say it's a great show. I hate Showtime sports. They suck.
Talk about the frustration that you hear from the Ontario fighters. It's a travesty. They can't even fight their own backyard.
I can't hear you.
Come on up, Joe.
Come on there, Johnny Whispers.
Yeah. Talk about the travesty from the Ontario fighters, and you hear from the guys that they can't even fight in their own backyard, that they got to be on the road and always come in as the away team.
Yeah, no, I agree. I think, you know, I think that's part of the frustration for the fighters and for the fans. You know, I was just talking about, you know, Canadians spend a lot of money to attend UFC events, and it'd be nice to just be able to walk down the street and go to the arena and see a fight.
Are you guys thinking about the TOF just for Canada?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
How about Quebec, just in French, for the Quebecois people?
What was the second part of that question?
How about the TOF in French for the Quebecois people and French people?
I don't know if we're going to break it down like that. We're going to do Canada. Okay. You know, I'm not getting into the politics and all that stuff.
Because in France, you guys are going to have a TOF, going to show a TOF, I think, on RTL.
We would do something so that Montreal could watch, you know, tough too. But what we're doing right now, and this is another one of my goals, is I want to take the Ultimate Fighter to all these different parts of the world. We're working on the Ultimate Fighter in the Middle East right now. That's going to happen probably soonest. I want to do one in the UK. I want to do one in Europe. I want to do this one in the UK and then do one for all of Europe for people where all these guys from different countries fight each other.
Oh, okay.
I'm working on all of that right now. That's been in the works for a while. And that isn't an easy one to pull off.
English with subtitles?
What's that?
English with subtitles?
Yeah, we'd have to subtitle, yeah.